So you typically have in the first semester you would have four class every semester you have four classes except your last one where you can have only two classes. So if you have four classes, then they are usually either Monday, Wednesday, Friday, or Tuesday, Thursday, or you could even have classes every day of the week. But it's not a typical 9-to-5 day like it is here. So you would just have maybe 2 hours of class a day, and then the rest of the day is free for you to do whatever you want. So it's around 2 hours every day, so around 10 hours a week, something like that. Like a fixed schedule, like how we had here in engineering. So it's not 9-to-5 and then every day of the week. It's a 2 year program if you do a thesis. If you choose not to do a thesis, then it's 1.5 year. You can stay longer if you want, but you don't, it's not, you could graduate and very few. Like people, it's mainly people who want to do PhD. Yeah, mainly the ones who are in that track, they do the thesis. Yeah.
So what you're saying is a 4 in the fall semester, 4 in the spring semester, and 2 in the fall semester.
Correct.
So a total of 10 courses.
10 courses, that's the minimum you require to graduate. You can take more classes, but it's not, they go above and beyond the mandatory how much you require. So the system that works here is that they have three groups. So you have three different areas. So when you join, you have to choose two technical interest groups. And those are your areas of specialization within EC. And so you have three groups from which you have to take at least. So you have three. So you had three classes that were mandatory from that group one. I think then there were three from group two, and then 4 elective. So you have 2 TIGs, 2 technical interest groups from which you can take 3 and 3. And then you have 2 elective classes that you can take. That's 4 credits. That's 3 classes from group one, 3 classes from group two, and 4 electives. You could even choose to take all 6. You have basically 6 classes that are mandatory that have to be within EC, and those 6 can be, so usually people take 2 technical interest groups, but you can even take all 6 from one. So it's something like that. So I've taken digital signal processing and telecommunication. So I had 4 classes from DSP and 2 classes from telecom, and my other 4 electives were from CS. Usually you max out your electives, so most people take all 4 from CS, and the remaining 6 are from EC. The CS classes are hard to get. EC ones you get easily. The ones from CS are usually on a wait list. And what happens is, we have a week-long registration, and on the last day of registration is when the wait list drops. Comes to like a first come first serve. Whoever gets the class gets it. In some cases, you can go and request the department that you really want the class. And if it is your final semester or you're graduating that semester, then you can. They do make some preference and they try to give you the classes that you want. So in the end, people do get the classes, but there's a little bit of a competition for the CS classes. Everyone is assigned a time ticket, which is basically at a particular time you can start your you can start enrolling for the classes, and that time is randomly given to everyone. So people could have a later afternoon time or an early morning time, so that's just luck. And then if you get a late time, then by the time you start, you're allowed to register, so the classes that you want could be filled out, and so then they have a wait list, so you're put on the wait list. And what happens in the first week of classes is that you can sit for the classes that you want, that you're interested in, and then you can decide whether you would want to take that class or you can drop it. So what happens is, if I've registered for say 10 classes and I'm going to take only 4 in the end, so the remaining 6 I'm going to drop out of. That's how, if people start dropping out, people on the waitlist start getting a chance to take that class, and that's how the waitlist process works. But on the last day, that it starts from a Monday to a Friday, so on a Friday, on the last day of registration, the waitlist drops, and if there are any seats that open up, then whoever is lucky gets it. So that's how it works. It's online, yeah, so you just keep refreshing. That's what people used to do. They would just keep refreshing the page again and again and again and keep trying for that class, and usually you do get it. Or if you have a friend, you know, who's taken that class and doesn't want it and is going to drop it, then you can ask him to tell you that, okay, I'm going to drop it now, so you be ready to take it. People used to do that too. Or if, and like in worst cases, you can go and request the department that I really want this class, and if it is possible, or request a professor, email them, or go talk to them. And some cases it did work out for people that they got the class in the last day. Yeah, I did actually for one of my, but it was my last semester, and there was this computer vision class that I really wanted. So I did go and ask in the department. I asked the department or the CS office, and I asked them that I told them I was graduating this semester and I really wanted the class, and they did accommodate me on the last day. So yeah, so it did work out.